As crystal bridges in the momentary, we recognize our role as settlers and guests in the Northwest Arkansas region. We acknowledge the Caddo, Quapaw, and Osage, as well as the many indigenous caretakers of this land and water. We appreciate the enduring influence of the vibrant, diverse, and contemporary cultures of indigenous peoples. We are conscious of the role in colonization that museums have played. As cultural institutions, we have a responsibility to engage in the dismantling of historical and systemic invisibility of indigenous peoples' past, present, and future. We choose to intentionally hold ourselves accountable to appropriate conversation, representation, connection, and education to facilitate a space of measurable change.
Hi.
This guy my neighbor found, and for 3 days we didn't know if he was going to live. He was all hooked up to IVs. But he's so big now. He's a total rascal. I've never had a real domesticated one. Like, he's annoying to sleep with because he's too much of a lover.
Right. He needs too much. All right. Are we good?
Okay.
Hi, Sarah.
Hi, Lauren.
So I'm Lauren Haynes, Director of Artist Initiatives and Curator of Contemporary Art at the Momentary in Crystal Bridges, and I'm here with Sarah Cain, a visual artist who we are thrilled to have Sarah Cain in nature here at the Momentary. Today, what we're going to do is a bit of a virtual walkthrough. This is really one of the first times that Sarah is seeing everything all complete and lit, and we're just going to talk about it. Right now, I'm going to flip the screen so you can sort of see what I'm looking at.
Oh, yeah.
And, yeah.
This is my first real finished walkthrough, too.
Oh, great. Well, then I'm going to move and walk you around so you can sort of see. If you want to start just talking a little bit overall about the exhibition and the project and how we work together, and then if there are certain works that we want to spend some more time on and talk about, we can do that as well.
Sure. I'm trying to think when the first site visit I did was. I think we've been working on this show for 2 years.
Right, it's been a couple of years.
Yeah. And the first visit, this was a hard hat area. We all had to get vests and hard hats, and this current lobby had tons of machinery in it. So that was my first experience, was walking through the construction site and being really into the space and curious to how it was going to come together as a museum. And then I came back for the opening of the museum to see the first show. And that the space was totally different.
That was about a year ago, right? Which is kind of crazy to think about.
Yeah, what a year. I really fell for that area in the back. Originally, there was a door there. So it's been cool to see how the space, you know, sank into its final form. But where the orange chair is, I always thought, okay, I want something there. And at first I thought it would be a painted sofa, but then with all the safety now, I wanted something that could be cleaned easier. But I was really into that as a viewing point because of that strange platform opposite, up way high, where the stained glass. So a lot of times I like move my body through the space, and I have these funny videos I made the first few times I was in the space. And I just sort of like, that originally, had I been on site, that would have been a massive painting, would have moved from window to wall to walkway down below. But because we had to adapt, and up there, I fell in love with that little chain on my first visit, which who knows what that was, but I think that probably was a staircase. The window, I think, was a door, and in my brain, that chain was something that kept people from, like, falling down the stairs. I don't know if that's what it is.
I don't know. I mean, I think with this building, there were just so many random leftovers from what it used to be. And so it's, yeah, not really sure what that chain was, but it definitely was in that specific position. And you were like, keep that chain. I would love to use it. And we're like, sure, no problem.
Yeah, and you mailed it to me, and it and when it got to my studio, I realized, oh, it's not one chain, it's two chains that lock in the center, which was, it's sort of, I don't know, I feel like that chain's sort of a good metaphor for how I work. Like, I saw something in the beginning, then on the, that was the first site visit. On the museum opening, I got, like, visually fascinated with someone wearing a really big gold chain on a blue cashmere sweater, and I was like, it's hard for me in crowds. I just lock into something visual, and that's what I remember, and I can't remember anything else. And then the third part of that chain being sent to me, I was like, oh, it's not one chain, it's two. And it reminded me of a relationship and two people hooking in the middle, and has a sweet rainbow painting that comes together and connects. And then as we realized I couldn't be there on site for the first, and also, because we did this floor map on the wall, and we had to plan, I am just learning late in life how to plan. So, it's the first show I've ever done that has, like, a very easy to follow theme. Like, my work tends to be pretty abstract and poetically out there in the themes, but I was so moved by Bentonville and the nature of it, and it really hit this nostalgic note for me about where I grew up in upstate New York, and the town center reminded me of the town center. So it was just all this, like, stuff that I realized is really in me that relates to nature and space, and how you would, like, move through a walk through the woods is very different than moving through, walking through Los Angeles, but it's innately how I view all spaces. And this is a dresser. This is from a body of work I did in 2015, where the idea was one object, one canvas. Those flowers look nice.
Yeah.
Always changing. That's round two, right?
They'll be different by tomorrow, too. So, yeah, this is the last day of these particular ones, and so we'll have new ones tomorrow.
I love that. That's for Cynthia, I think, for Cynthia. The yellow flower, it's like in upstate New York, that's how you know spring's coming. It's the first bush, that with the crocuses, but that looks great. So this one, when we installed, if you walk back a little more, I was really set on the concentric square in this dresser lining up with the concentric square in the painting behind it, which was a new painting I made. I really wanted it to tie into the portrait to the left. Those canvases are the same size. They're both 90 by 90. So a lot of times, like, when I'm planning a show, I'll think about little relationships between the work, whether it's, like, an echo of one thing moving into another or a size. Like, I do this doubling thing a lot. This one's a self-portrait, which I think I was working on this around the time that we were getting serious thinking about the show, and it has the center spine of prisms, or the center has a line of prisms, which I think of as, like, the spine of the painting, and it's a bit of an emotional roller coaster, just sorting your stuff out, moving through the day, and even though this was a self-portrait of a year that personally was really difficult for me, I felt like by the time I personally stabilized, then the whole world went down. So right. I felt like this portrait really was like, okay, just hang on. Like, you know, we're gonna get through this all together. It's sort of silly the way I start thinking about them, but they become like people or objects or moments in time. And the time, like, can fluctuate. The one to the left has all these color copies of ribbons that I took, like, 20 years ago from when my grandmother passed away. She sewed a lot, and she had this, and I guess, like, I don't really have artists in my family, but I had quilters, so I had these, like, ribbons that have shown up in my work over the years, and then that plant is the plant that blooms in front of my studio here in Los Angeles. So there's this compression of time and memory and people making new compositions.
I think for me, one of the really exciting things was how you were able to, you know, pivot in a way, but also really think expansively about some of the challenges that COVID did cause us to have, right? And the fact that you wouldn't actually be able to be here for install, and there were certain things we needed to plan out in a different way. And just that sort of part of the process, I think it went, you know, as well as it could have gone. And I think it really gave us a really lovely exhibition here.
Oh, I'm glad you think so. I do, yeah. Too. It is so exciting to see it done. And I, even though I haven't seen it in person yet, I really feel like it did arrive. That painting and that wavy one behind the floor actually is called Pollinator. And that was related to this hummingbird's nest. Those are the colors. I mean, not exactly, but basically from my observation of what's flowering in my yard, those are the plants that the hummingbird would go to. And it has all the lines are beaded. So a lot of times the canvas have these collage elements. So all the paintings also have nature themes. Like the one to the left over there is called Black Widow, which that I have so many widows. I have a lot of brown widows in my yard, but now I know what the eggs look like. And it was an intense part about moving to this property, getting to know the Black Widow. I wanted to talk about that funny little bark on the wall that to me looks like, it looks like bad 1980s or good bad 1980s cover art or something for like an album. I pulled this, well, it was like basically off the tree. I just gave it a little tiny tug. When was that? Like, I don't know. I found that maybe 16 years ago in the Los Angeles National Forest. It's a real piece of bark, and it has carved in there 1226 AD something. So it's a pretty old lover's heartbreak that broke right in the middle. Which I've been holding this and wanting to, like, at first I wanted to cast it in rose gold, and then I realized that I couldn't afford that. I didn't want to pay all that money. So this is a variegated gold leaf and paint. And it's like, it's kind of atrocious the way it looks, but also it's so the 80s, and it's called Heartbreaker. Like, it just reminds me of some, like, hair band something, like, you know. I don't know, like I can feel the hairspray in whoever carved that. Yeah. That was satisfying to finally find a home for it.
Yeah. It's nice when that sort of all comes together. Something that you've had in your studio and been thinking about for a while really finds its place in a project and something that you're working on.
Yeah, it's surprising. You never know when it's going to happen, but I think that's a little part, like, I think about collage a lot, but I am one of those artists that just holds on to things until it's right. Also, I try to get rid of things. Like, the one painting we haven't spoken of, Sky and Sea, which I really love. My mother always sends me things. Some are great. And some I'm like, stop. But she sent me this hilarious, like, that thing that hangs down the middle with all the mirrors. And I'm like, I'm not going to hang that in my house. but it could be the start of a really great painting. So in a way, this whole painting kind of grew out of this object that I was looking at and the seashells that I had just collected. That's a funny one. I go to the botanical gardens here a lot, and it blows my mind. Like, I think that I know every plant in there because I go at least once a week, but you can never know nature. Like, nature's the core of everything, and it's always surprising.
That's absolutely. I think that's so true. I don't know, Sarah, anything else you want to say? Anything else we want to talk about?
I mean, it's been a pleasure working with you all. I can't wait to get there.
Yes.
I'm waiting my place in line, but I'm being morally responsible. But as soon as I can get vaccinated, I'm there.
Great. Yes. Very hopeful and excited that, you know, Sarah Cain and Nature will be on view until May 30th. So hopefully that gives people plenty of time to come and visit and see this great exhibition. And Sarah, it's been, as always, a pleasure talking with you. And I hope even though, you know, the exhibition is up, we will still stay in contact. You will still continue to send me pictures of cats, all of the things that are very important. And really look forward to seeing how our visitors enjoy and engage with your exhibition.
Me too. It's been great to see pictures posted already. It made actually made me, because I had another show open in the pandemic, which felt so uneventful, but there's been a lot of like people in the space, and it, I don't know, it made me realize how important all sides of an opening are.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Thanks, Lauren.
Awesome.
Okay. Thank Talk you. To you soon. Okay. So I'll sign off from everything. Okay.